So let us discuss the sixth question. So in the sixth question, we have to calculate the domain of the function h, where h is given as the composition function, the composite function f compose g, where f is given as x square minus 8x plus 15 by x plus 3. So we can write it as f of x, as it is a function of x. And g of x is square root of x square minus 4. So we have to calculate what is the domain of the function h. So hx is nothing but f of g of x. So how will we compute the domain of hx? Observe that the input value of h firstly comes from the input value of g. So let us begin with computing what is the domain of gx, I mean from where the g is taking its input. So to begin with, calculate. So this is the first step, calculate the domain of g. So you have seen earlier the domain of g is nothing but minus infinity to 2 closed interval union, minus infinity to minus 2 closed interval union plus 2 to plus infinity. So this is the domain of g. So from this set, g is taking its input. Now if we take input from this set, then we'll get some values as output from g, and those output, basically those are in the range of g, and those output must be inside the domain of f, otherwise the f will not define, right? So let us compute what is the range of g. So you have seen that this is a square root function, so range of g is nothing but 0 to infinity. So it is nothing but the non-negative real numbers. Now let us ask the question, is f defined on whole range of g? This is the question. If f is defined on the whole, that means if I am giving the input in the f here in f compose g in the whole range of g, I mean whatever the outputs coming from g is accepted as the input of f, then the domain of the function is nothing but the domain of g, because domain of g means we are giving input. So let me write, this is my g and this is my f, so we are giving input, getting some output, and if all the output elements, I mean if all this set, if everything is in the output set is taken as the input of f, then these inputs, this set is nothing but the domain of h. So here let us observe what is the domain of f, I mean what inputs f can take. So domain of f is nothing but all the real numbers except minus 3. But observe that minus 3 is not in the range of g, because range of g is nothing but non-negative real numbers. So minus 3 is not there. So anything in the which is in the range of g can be taken as input in the f. So whatever I am giving input in the g, we are getting some output, and all the outputs are taken as the input of f. So the domain of h here is nothing but domain of g. Remember, this is for this particular case. There may be some cases where this range of g, the whatever I am getting as the range of g, cannot all the elements may not be taken as an input of f. There can be some cases, I will show an example there. But in this particular case, in this question number 6, we are seeing that domain of g is nothing but domain of age, because the range set is basically a subset of domain of f. So let me write here. So let me finish this at first. So domain of g is nothing but this thing, minus infinity to minus 2 union 2 to infinity. So this is the domain of h. Okay, so what we have seen here, we have seen that to find the domain of some composite function f compose g, the step one, we must calculate what is domain of g. If we calculate domain of g, then we have to calculate. So let me write this as hx equal to f compose gx. So it is nothing but f of gx. So these things are, this gx, these are in range of g. So step two must be calculating range of g. Now there some cases can arise. So if case one, if range of g is subset of domain of f, which we have seen in the question number 6, which we have seen in the example we have just discussed. If range of g is subset of domain of f, then see, every value which are in the output of g can be taken as input in f. So no problem arises. So domain of the composite function f compose g is same as domain of g. So this is domain of g, this is range of g. Okay. So this is case one. Now, what other case can arise? So let us see another example before going to the case two. So I am taking my fx to be 1 by x minus 3, and let g be the same, root over x square minus 4. So what are the steps? Step 1, we have seen domain of g. Domain of g is nothing but, we have already seen, this union. Step 2, range of g. So range of g is nothing but 0 to infinity. Now we come to the case 1. Is this happens? Is range of g is a subset of range of domain of f? So let us calculate domain of f. Domain of f is set of all real number except 3, because when we put 3, this will become undefined, otherwise it is defined everywhere. So domain of f is real number, set of real number, minus the singleton set 3. So you can see that this 3 is in range of g. So we are getting some output from g which is not in the domain of f. So we cannot give that value in g for which this 3 is coming. So we cannot put that x as input for which g of x is 3, because in that case this f3, this is not defined, right? So we have to find those x in the domain of g for which g of x is 3, and we will cut those element out. So what is g of x is 3? G of x is root over x square minus 4 equal to 3. So if we solve this, we will get x square minus 4 equal to 9. So x square equal to 13, which implies x is equal to plus minus root 13. So for these two values, plus root 13 and minus root 13, we are getting the output as 3, which cannot be given as input in f. So we have to eliminate this from the domain. So in this case, we have already seen domain of G is this. So we have to eliminate this plus root 13 from this side and minus root 13 from this side. So plus root 13 from this side and minus root 13 from this side. So eventually our domain of A, H, is minus infinity to minus root 13. And again, union minus root 13, because we are eliminating minus root 13. So minus root 13 to minus 2. This should be closed interval, as it is there. 2 to plus root 13. See, plus root 13 is greater than 2. You can check. So this union plus root 13 to infinity. So this is the this union of these four intervals. This is the domain of H in this case. So where H is F compose G, where F is this one and G is this one. So let us write me as example 1. So here you have observed that here case 1 is not satisfying. So we are going to some other case. So let me write it. Case 2, if range of G is not a subset of domain of A, then eliminate all those element, all those elements from range of G for which F is not defined. What does it mean? It means eliminate all those element from range of G which are not in the domain of F. What does it mean by elimination here? So we have to eliminate from the domain of G which element from the domain we have to eliminate, for which we are getting those element in the range of G which are not in the domain of F. So this is my final conclusion. So let us recall the steps. Step 1, find domain of G. Step 2, find range of G. Now, after that, two cases will arrive. So, before going to the two cases, it's better to calculate what is domain of F. What is domain of F? Now, observe if, now case 1, if range of G is subset of domain of F, then it's easy, then domain of F compose G is same as domain of G. Case 2, if range of G is not subset of domain of F, then what we have to do? We have to do this thing. So let me write it as A star, then do A star. So this is the stepwise procedure to calculate the domain of F compose G. Now you may ask, what is the problem if we calculate the F compose G beforehand and then solve this, find the domain? So what I mean here, let fx equal to x square, gx equal to root x. So what is F compose G here? So F compose G of x is f of g of x is root x, so root x whole square, that means x. So you see that if we calculate this f compose g beforehand, you can see, so this is our hx. So as a function hx, the domain of hx, if I write only this thing, so what is the domain of this thing? This is whole real number. Domain of h, let me write this, domain of h is whole real number. But when I am getting hx as a composite function, f compose g, then is g defined on whole R? It is not the case. So domain of g, what is domain of g? Domain of g is only non-negative real numbers, because we cannot put negative real numbers under the square root, otherwise it will give us complex values. So domain of g for real valued function is close 0, open infinity, only the non-negative real numbers. So this f compose g, the domain of f compose g must be a subset of this, and if you calculate as we have stated the steps previously, then you will get domain of f compose g is nothing but domain of g, which is 0 to infinity. But if we calculate the f compose g beforehand and then try to find what is the domain, then you will get domain of h is r, which is not the case. So this is the correct one. So you have to follow the procedure which I have stated in this page. So this is the correct procedure to find domain of f compose g. Thank you.